it's the visit with a person of high strangeness. Would you please push the record button on your VCR or recorder that you have there? And here's the reason. This is the first of 5 review shows of all the shows that we did over the years. I'm going to tell you a story here. During a snowstorm in 1998, I came to the studio to film a show about ufology, and this was supposed to be a one-time thing. And but it was so well received that we couldn't very well stop. So I don't know if it was the music, the opening music. I don't know if it was the relaxed atmosphere or the subject we picked. Well, either way, the way it turned out that I got so many phone calls I couldn't quite stop. The first show was that I wanted to prove a point. And I had written a book and I went on the talk show circuit and I didn't like people the way people were doing things. And so I thought, I'm just going to do this myself once. Well, in the meantime, we have 5 shows here, which would make it 10 years. And so what we're going to do, we're going to review all the shows that were ever done by me. And, I'm a little sad because, in case you haven't noticed, I'm getting ready to quit the shows here. And so where we're going today is 1999. And so 1999 and 2000, actually. And so I'm not doing this very well, but that's okay. So just push your recorder so you know you have a general idea, and things will be available to you on video if you call me and tell me which ones you want. This is just a little reminder. We're gonna actually do this for 5 weeks and going to go through everything we ever did on the visit with a person of high strangeness. And then I guess in between I'll tell you some of the other behind the scenes stories. So did you push that button? Because we're getting ready to give you the review of 1999, and actually there's the one show from 1998 on there that we that started the whole thing, you know. And immediately I brought a lion spear into the studio. I didn't know it was considered a weapon, so Miss Debbie, our director, had to have a long talk with me as to what I can bring into the studio and what not, and weapons was not one of them. So I said okay, and I didn't bring another weapon after that, so just so you know. Beautiful lion spear. It came from Kenya. And so I think we'll get going. And you did say that you pushed the button, right? Okay. So here it is. One show in 1998, and the rest of them are 1999. So enjoy.
Oh, how cool. Yeah. Well, they're coming from somewhere else, so I'm supposing it takes a few minutes. Here we go. These are the friends at Action Auto in Lacey. And Donna, the lady with the baby, was a camera person. This, oh geez, too fast, but that's okay. This is a studio person, Patrick. The gentleman before that, was from the Prime Connection. And this is the Office Depot. No, I'm sorry, the good guys. And they were all too happy to wave at you, and there she goes. Isn't that great? And this is a gentleman that recognized me and put a card in the window and waved. Tradition Cafe finishes my clothes. Some of the props come from Reggie's Design on 4th Avenue. That is Reggie himself and his lady Janice. Two of my camera people, which are also my grandchildren, Destiny Wells In Ebony Moor, there you go, just waving. They work very, very hard. In the winter time when we need a tan, that's where we go and get it, you know, they accommodate us. And then this is Stephen Maddox, the gentleman you met a minute ago. That is his office. And he was also happy to wave at you also. And there he is with some of his children. And during the food drive that we had, we needed repairs to the crapper, and it's this Dunride Auto that helped with the brake system and did a lot of work to make the food drive possible that we did in conjunction with Chaos and Justin Weitschel and some people in Peonia, Colorado. They worked very hard, and boy, it stops on a dime. Look at it. That allowed us to get some shows and bring back and share with you. Here's some of the mechanics. Everybody's just smiling. There you go. This is Beidous. They were very instrumental in information that we needed to pull this off, and we do thank them. Alan's Auto Part made sure the tires were wonderful. Then here, this is a friend up in Lacey. And total blank. I can't remember her name. I'm so sorry. But I do remember the wonderful pastries she sends for the crew. And this is the office depot and the lady that puts my opening shots together for me. She was taking a break. There she goes waving. These are some people from a local healthcare provider that have done clips and otherwise supported me. And they had such a good time. And then what happened is the rest of the office appeared right behind them, and they wanted to say hello to the friends of Olympia also, people that made these shows possible. Oh, I have to get, there he is. Jim Clarkson, he's the UFO investigator from Aberdeen. I couldn't see the monitor, so I didn't know where I was. How about that? And we have done a total of three with him. This is Barbara McGuire. I think you recognize her. She has been here the most. This was Can You Tell Me the Time? We talked about time shifts and changes on our way to Aberdeen, and we have experienced.
Oh, yes, we have.
Well, you think it's 1 minute and then there's another. Here's Barbara McGuire again. We advised you how to pick a clairvoyant, what to look for, and just how to pick a good psychic or a clairvoyant. Then you've met Barbara also.
Oh,
no?
Yeah, she's a very nice person.
Yeah, very knowledgeable. And then this is Monica Ryan Smith, a friend from Anchorage. This was the show 2 for 1, where we took you to the Navajo and the Hopi reservations and shared our trip where she fell in the hole.
Yeah.
you was with us here. This was an exclusive interview, the June Kaaba story with Jim Clarkson and Barbara McGuire.
Yes.
At the Cooney Mansion. This is Nancy Williams. This one was May I Ask Your Age? And it dealt with the primal scream.
That was one of my favorite of all the shows.
I'm almost thinking it was mine too, because it so came from the heart. And then here's Barbara again. We talked about things that make you go, And Electro-Arn. We discussed Electro-Arn and the Wingmakers. Then this was Universal and Man-Made, a lady named Jana. She talked about the upcoming summer eclipse, at sun eclipse at that time. And we shared conversations about HARP, the project in Alaska, with you. And then this was Take Two Aspens and Call Me in the AM with Rose White. And we also played music that someone recorded, and these are sounds that's in the universe and planetary, a man named Bill Ramsey. Monica Ryan Smith again, Strangeness Times 2, where she explained to you who she is as a healer. Wonderful healer, huh?
Yes.
And then this is my friend Roger Duncan. He is a mind guru, and he has his program on Channel 44 in Anchorage, and responsible for putting, for transferring the tapes onto their equipment.
There's Barbara again at the Cooney Mansion, and I can't remember her name.
Judy Lore.
Judy, that owns it.
Mm-hmm. At the Cooney Mansion. Ha! Huh. This was the two-parter based on the NBC special Confirmation. This is Alien Hunter. Daryl Sims.
Daryl Sims.
The interviewer is Brenda Roberts. Daryl removes implants from alien abductees and can be found on my webpage. This is Mr. Al Bielik. He is one of the surviving sailors that was involved with the Philadelphia experiment. A wonderful human being. And we should have acknowledged him on the Ageless show, but we didn't.
Oh, yes.
These were the physical guests in the studio, Barbara and her and Carol Wright. This is David Adair, a space industrialist that built the first rocket that landed. He was 17 years old, and the rocket landed in White Sands. And based on some of their technology, the space program was founded. Here, Barbara and Carol again in the second part of their two-part show. Preston Nichols, very many of you are familiar with him. He is a gentleman that works with timelines, explaining how time is not linear. And this is Barbara McGuire again, and we hope you have a ghostly time. We shared ghost stories with you and interviewed people in Aberdeen area. Paranormal, what is paranormal in German? Claudia Kramer, my niece, and the interpreter, Elfie. This is the Crop Circle show. Colin Andrews, the head of the Crop Circle Connector in the United Kingdom. Here I am, I was the guest. Barbara was the hostess,
yes,
talking about my experiences in the Crop Circles. Eilis, the coordinator of Crop Circle Studies for the U.S. Here she explains how crop circles are being formed. She used to live local in the Olympia area. This is Busty Taylor, the wonderful pilot the photographer that gives us the pictures. First, the music show, Jar Spencer. He was also on the blooper show trying to play his trumpet. We had fun with that. This was a location shot of the second music show, a young man named Zechariah. A location shot at Tommy Park, him playing a didgeridoo. And here is Zechariah on the second part of his music show, playing the didgeridoo in the studio. This one dealt with indigenous people, and here she, Barbara McGuire, explained how to smudge and how to make feathers. This is a UFO that was taken about a man named Tom Walker, right above St. Martin's College. That was a favorite.
Yeah.
People liked it. And this is the ghost that appeared on a television set in Atlanta, Georgia. Spirit Wolf worked on that case. And here's Barbara again in the show Tidbits and Bloopers. Excuse me. We have showed you all the bloopers we made. This was the 8th show with Yana G.
And there's Missy T in her bowl.
In her bowl. She was the centerpiece. That was the T.L. Wampa show. Wonderful, huh? She likes coming to the studio.
She likes getting all the camera on her.
Yeah, she does. Here is Barbara McGuire again on the Lop Sing Wampa tribute show. That's the one that's on the webpage. And then this was ETs and the Media, a young gentleman named Lucius that had agreed to debate with me, and before it was all said and done, we agreed on everything. That was a very good show, and I enjoyed this young person too.
Yeah.
This was Disability, the Disability show, Paula Bonine with her daughter Ashley that has cerebral palsy. It was a very moving and educational show. Very moving show. This is Margaret Brennan. Here you met her as the artist. She's a local lady, and we showed off her early art and then what we painted in a house in early African art, in primitive art. Kitty Mady from Monteseno, in my opinion, the best herbalist in Washington State. Mm-hmm. She came to share remedies. You met her too, no?
Yes, I have.
Yeah. Then this is Paula Bonine with her rocks in Rocky Road. No, we don't mean ice cream. All the rocks she found at the Wainuchi River in Grace Harbeck County. Mm-hmm. Wonderful. Here is Margaret Brennan and myself. That was Let Me Kiss Your Hand, Madame. We shared, we swapped stories about dignitaries we met, her and family friendship with the Pope. Mine, I met the Queen of England, the Kennedys, and she met the Shah of Persia. Barbara McGuire again. I believe that was the show Starseed, where a faraway guest was Spirit Wolf. She gave her indigenous ideas on Starseed. Monica Ryan Smith, we talked about chaos. We had interviewed people and we realized there was a lot of confusion between chaos and stress. Margaret Brennan again. This is where we took you shopping. We went to all the local merchants in Olympia, and we had a ball with that. This was one of my bilingual shows, Sharon Medal. Was the first of the water shows where she translated about the clustered water into Korean. She was our Korean interpreter at that time. Wonderful being. And that was the first of the second one of the bilingual ones. And this is Akhenaten. He came down from Seattle. He shared his connection to the ancient Egyptians. This was another show where he talked about Mayan cosmology and his connection to the Mayans. Bertie Rodriguez, the educator, that helped me tackle the Indigo children, and that's the show we had Nick on the...
Yes.
The youngest...
handwriting analysis in the world.
In the world, yeah. She helped me with that. That was a wonderful show, too. Here's Monica Ryan Smith again. Fear is not a t-shirt. We talked about people's fears that they had. And that was a pretty good show too, I thought. She comes down from Alaska whenever she can to share stories with you. Yeah. The fire alarm went off on this one. The first of the homeless shows, a woman named Ezekiel telling about her early times as a homeless person on the streets of Seattle. Then later she helped raise $100,000 with the late Jan Stanford for the homeless people in Seattle. She now educates people about homeless children in particular. And this was the show called Ageless Wisdom, Electra Ann from North Carolina. Mm-hmm. We ran into her in Pueblo. In Pueblo, Colorado. Wonderful being. But the oldest light worker I know, in fact. And this is Edie. She's also one of my camera people. The name of this show was Personal Growth. And this is Barbara McGuire again. God, I can. Oh, this is the second of the Ezekiel shows about the homeless, where she explained that if you tame something, you become responsible for it. The one before that was our death show, the one with Barbara. And then this was Tammy, a Bauer. We talked about the ghost on Hot Lakes.
Yes.
In that we investigated in.
They haven't seen that show yet.
In Union, Washington.
In Union, Washington.
Yeah, well, yes. I make sure you get a copy of it. This was Black Pioneers in Roslyn, Washington. Kanashiba-san.
Mm-hmm. She is a very brilliant, wonderful psychic.
Mm-hmm. And there's Dr. Lorenzen from the Clustered Water and Mr. Chung, the Korean pharmacist. This show was actually in Korean and it got translated into English. So we did that backwards, you know, but not really because it was one of the favorites, talking about clustered water. We covered that 3 times, each time from a different angle. Yeah. And it was Kanashiba-san,
uh-huh,
as a psychic.
Yes.
She shared her gifts as a psychic and we did readings for a young lady named Tara and her 14-day-old baby. This was so,
aww, that
this
would've been neat.
So exciting. Yeah.
Yes.
This is Dr. Lorenzen again talking about his water clusters. That was a good show too.
Mm-hmm. Very knowledgeable.
And Gian, the lady from Vietnam, that shared some of her early stories from Vietnam and then some of her life in the United States. That was a good one too. And then Wayne Buckner. That was the dog show, and this is Jenny, our unisex dog, that in the meantime got adopted. And there was a show on greyhounds and needing to be adopted. This is the Cavanza show, a woman named Matisse and Beverly Ferris. We gave you a crash course in Cavanza, and we heard you enjoyed that. And here is Matisse and myself talking about her travels with Barbara Maciniak and out-of-body experiences. And that's the show, by the way, that I broke my leg on because I wasn't all in. And there you are.
In the ball.
In the ball. Quick trip to Colorado.
Yeah.
And we thought that was really great, too.
By now it had become apparent that it was very hard to get people to help. And so what we did is we recruited the friends, some of the friends, and my grandchildren to come and help me. So they went and took classes so they could come and assist me as camera people and in the field. So we started out with a couple of grown-ups and my grandchildren. Now Destiny at the time, she liked to go outside and do the shots. And then Ebony, she didn't really care what we did, she just wanted to help. And my grandson Malcolm at the time, he decided to wait till he was 8 years old and then he said he would help. And so with the help of the friends and the grandkids, I had a full camera crew, and of course I had staff and Bernie that ran the control room for us. And the subjects we brought in, people really liked it. We didn't want to be perfect, that was too complicated. So what we did is we inserted different pieces and things so that if we actually did make a boo-boo, you didn't notice it. And then it got to the point where you was actually looking to see whether you could determine if this was an actual boo-boo or whether we had put something in there on purpose, and we made it a fun thing. So let's go to the year 2000. And see what all we came up with then.
From Peel,
no,
the person.
No, that's Dazzy. We saw it in the middle of the clip. Dazzy. Okay, this is Dazzy, a lady from Alaska, and she came to visit with us. And then, yeah, still between two worlds. with Guillaume, and that was her second visit with us here at the studio. And we kind of gave you an update of what
wisdom comes with age, maybe.
That's kind of Shiba-san. We was talking about getting old and some of the lessons that we had learned. Kind of Shiba-san lives in Roslyn, Washington. And she came here 3 or 4 times in the last 2 years. I think she was here twice.
Bon voyage.
Yes, that is Serena. And she talked me through my trips this summer. And at another time she came and shared some of her own personal stories. And that was sort of a fun story we did there to take them all on.
Mm-hmm. This is Fox, X Factor.
X Factor. He's an English teacher from England that now lives in Slovakia. And he was visiting one of the friends in Grand Junction, and he was on loan.
This is Medical Intuitive.
This is Dr. Vladimir Lysenkov from a retired Russian surgeon. He demonstrated how medical intuitives practice their craft. And then that, of course, is his wife, Dalze, and Margaret Brennan. She was our patient for the day. And yours truly, a lot of calls on this one. Lots of calls on this show. Always appreciate when the friends call. You get calls too sometimes, don't
mm-hmm.
you?
Yes.
Yeah, lots of questions people have. And
okay, this is Green Eyes, Wanderers, Walk-ins, and Shapeshifters.
This is Serena again. This is the show where we showed you the eyeballs, where this man went into a cave, and several days later his eyes started changing. And that is a documented case where eyes turned to green because something in the DNA had changed. And that was a documented case that we shared with you.
This is foster care. Oh, this is when you disappear.
I did. I disappeared. but, you know, we sort of did that on purpose simply because we wanted to show that sometimes when you talk about things, people just don't hear you. It's like talking to an empty chair, and she did. Ezekiel is her name. There she is.
Mm-hmm.
Wonderful lady. Her and I did the homeless shows in 1999. So this was a follow-up. See you up there. I am.
There you go.
Yeah, I'm not. it did that all through the show, but it was done on purpose.
Okay, this is Prisons, Food for Thought.
These are two of the volunteers that go into the state prison in Pretty to volunteer, and they gave their ideas and thoughts on the interactions with the prison rights and what they thought should be changed as far as human rights issues concerned. That was a very, very popular show. And I believe both of their names was Jennifer. If I got that right, I apologize. I'm so bad on names. Lots of calls on that show.
Okay, this is Emotional Intelligence.
This is Catherine Peels. We did a series of 4 with her. And there we met her as a person. And she was talking about how she was just about blind. You know, and she had just got her eyes fixed. And in some of the work she does, and she's the lady that had the Edison light bulb.
Oh, she was, that? Yes.
Mm-hmm. Yeah, really wonderful person.
Real delicate bulb.
Yes, she was, yeah. Mm-hmm. She did. And she came on 4 times.
And that's Barbara McGuire. This show is called Greenview. That's where they had the big UFO incident.
Right, she's reading the UFO report from Greenville that got to be so famous, even though a week earlier I was in Greenville and reported that same craft twice. I just didn't see it so close and we didn't have pictures of it. Barbara is not feeling well, so this is the only show that we did with her in that year.
This is Intuitive Prosperity.
Dana Sebo, very familiar with Olympian Anchorage people. She goes to Anchorage quite often for lectures and workshops, and she came to visit with us, and that was an exciting day.
Mm-hmm. Mm-hmm.
She showed us how to change the our line of thinking so we can be intuitive and prosperous at the
yes.
same time.
Mm-hmm. This is Rude Awakening to Mental Illness.
This is Mona. She is a paranoid schizophrenic, and she came and shared with us what happens to her when she goes through her trauma. And Catherine Peels documented that on the end, and I was so proud of Mona for having come forward. It was a very, very valuable show and a very valuable lesson for all of us. And Mona, if you're watching this, I do appreciate your courage and thank you for coming.
This is Emotional Feedback, What and How.
That was the first one from the series where Catherine explained her work, how it worked and what she does with it, and very popular. And she moved out of the area now. She is working as with the scientists now. And but if anyone needs to get a hold of her, I can accommodate that.
This is From Host to Host.
Justin B. Wright, my former director here, he has a show called Dance or Dance, and a lot of people couldn't understand his line of thinking behind it. So we kicked it around of how the challenges we run into with ideas and that we like to let people know, and finances and the lack of, and how we can sometimes get help from people. And he's showing off his grasshopper there. And that is Justin. And
this is Crime and Corruption Part 1.
Evelyn Cessna. She shared what happened to her in the 70s. It was an insurance scandal that sort of rocked the Washington area. And she has a lot of courage for coming forward. She first time she ever told her story, and we want to thank her too, especially for having come forward to do that.
This show is UFO Snippets.
Yeah, that's Jim Clarkston. We was kicking around Majestic 12 and how come our money is counterfeit and all kinds of just thoughts and things.
Serena.
That is Serena as a person. On that show, she did a reading for me and said when I go on my next trip, mm-hmm. it would not be a good one and out of the ordinary, and sure enough.
And it sure was.
The one in Greenville where I got stuck.
Yes, you mm-hmm. did.
So how right she was. I couldn't believe it. Because sometimes we say something, of course, we don't know who that is.
Right. This is Tripod.
Yep, this was a lady named Lucia Hager, a man named Baba Roosh, and Lisa Bilski. And she was showing how you can use this, I think she called it a rebounder, how you can use that for therapy. And
this is Prescription Laughter.
Mike Wally Walters, one of our local gentlemen, he's an internationally known
comedian.
Yeah, we had fun with him. And he travels all over with big bands. And we found him sitting at the river in Olympia one day, and he came.
Predictions 2001.
Ha. That was a mind blower. We was predicting the year 2001 on the 30th of October. We talked about the mess of the election that had not even happened yet. And it being December, and we still don't know who the president is.
No, unfortunately.
This whole show was so prophetic, you know, because when we say things, you know, sometimes you don't know what it is, but.
Exactly.
I think we need to rerun this one again.
Yeah, it would be good. This is called Justice.
He again, this is Ezekiel. She, in order to get therapy for some of the things she experienced, she had to sue her parents to make them liable, and she actually did that and came out really good. So we were happy about that, very happy. That was a good show too. Mm-hmm. And I only disappeared once on that one.
A visit to Roswell.
Jim and Joanne Clarkson, they went to Roswell and brought back goodies and shared their experiences with us. They come to Olympia, Washington to do lectures at the library.
Yeah. Mm-hmm.
So if you get a chance, go see him. Lucia.
Yeah.
Mm-hmm. Lucia, here you meet her as a person. She is originally from Switzerland, and she talked about her travels. I think she went to Bali or Burma. I don't remember which country, but she gave us a little rundown on who she was and what brought her here.
This is Talk Shop and Spiritual Maintenance.
Yeah. You was on that show.
Uh-huh.
Ilea Leland, Tammy Bauer, and Irene
McNabb.
We had never met her. She came from Canada.
Yes.
And there's a gentleman, and I can't pronounce his name, but it's listed on the clip there. He wrote this song for the immigrants that come across the Mexican border, and it was pretty incredible.
It was. It was very nice.
Yeah, very moving. Yeah.
This is Ready or Not.
Yep, this is Fox again. He had brought footage from John Hutchinson, the gentleman that works with Tesla Coil.
This is Crime and Corruption Part 2.
Mm-hmm. Evelyn Cessna again. That was the only two-part that we had because we couldn't tell it all in one sitting. And she had so many pictures, you know. It was
quite a story she had, too.
Mm-hmm.
This one, Encounters at Hopi Land.
Yeah, here you are. That's the Fred Palmer show.
Mm-hmm.
He helped me host that, and which was Encounter at Hopi Land. A man named Fred Palmer. We taped that in Colorado.
Right.
Mm-hmm.
Mm-hmm. Hotchkiss.
Yeah, we taped it in Hotchkiss and then brought it. There he is.
There he is. Mm-hmm.
They kept interfering with me, remember? And I would roll my eyes at him. And this is the Train Life bracelet in there. The hieroglyphics at the Hopi Reservation with me not having hair. Monica Ryan Smith. And that was a pretty incredible story, huh?
Yes, it was.
Mm-hmm. Those are some of Randolph Winter's UFOs over his head.
This show is Using Emotional Intelligence. Mm-hmm.
That's when we finally figured out what all we had to do. She finally showed us how to use it. Catherine Peels. Mm-hmm. She's so exciting. See, oh, that's one of the shows. I was blue.
You were blue.
I was blue, yeah. Totally blue. Yeah, we certainly miss Catherine dropping by here. And this was a closing shot for the shop talk. Courtesy of Bernie's musical show that I think it runs on Saturday. Don't remember what his show is called, but he was nice enough to let us use inserts, and that was our closing music, and that was pretty incredible too.
Yes, This is Big Mountain Magic.
Larry Dodge himself, the postcard man, he calls himself. He came to see some of his work there. That was an experience.
That's pretty.
Yeah. The friends helped us to get him into the studio. He lives in Wyoming, and people donated plane tickets and hotel rooms, and it was pretty incredible. Mm-hmm. Wonderful time we had. Yeah. And then these are...
Jury duty.
Patricia Michael, Tom Stahl. Those are the friends that brought the opening shot for today. They went to the Four Corners to bring the sand painting for me just a few days ago.
Yeah.
Mm-hmm. They went, yeah.
Surviving L and I.
Oh boy. We got a race out of that one. A race out of that one. And you got a race out of it, right?
Yes.
You won your
Say
case.
The least. Yes, I did.
That show was instrumental in changing a lot of things for people on L&I, so We are very modest here, to say the least. Yeah.
Yes.
Stirred up a lot of stuff, but we enjoyed sharing it with you. And people still come over. They say, "I'm on LNI. Let me see that." So, yeah. So there's two elephants.
There's my elephants. Mm-hmm. Two of them.
Yeah, one of them you broke the trunk off, remember?
Yes.
The little guy. That was a very educational show from a personal perspective.
This is my friends at White Phoenix. Our friends.
Our friends, right, from Florence, Colorado. This is Martin at the White Phoenix. He's also a tattoo artist, and we were visiting, and we talked about the differences sometimes people make, even if you come to town for a day or two.
Mm-hmm.
It was right after the radio show we did.
Yeah.
that you could even say tattoo.
Yeah.
On that radio station, and we talked about mutilation. This is his wife, Denise. She works for the state, and we talked about welfare reforms in Colorado, in the state of Colorado, and we smoked.
This is 4 divided by 2 plus 1 equals 1.
That was the show where we talked about the relocation of the Dene people at the Four Corners area. I think big mountains. And then the pictures, these pictures right here, that is Evelyn, I'm sorry, Catherine Peel's brother. And he's also the brother of E.T. Turnbull, whose music you are hearing today. And we found those at the Beaujardais Art Gallery. Mm-hmm.
Mm-hmm.
So a lot of family treasures here from Catherine Peel's family.
Storytelling.
Dana Sibo, talking about her new book. I think it's called 8 Pennies. That was really early in the year. And that was early in the year. She came and spent a couple of weeks with us. 2 visits, I think it was. I don't remember.
She writes children's books.
Children's books. Mm-hmm. Yeah, 8 Pennies and God's Kiss is one of her books. And they won awards. Mm-hmm. Ah.
100th show.
I'm having on the same dress with a different hat. That was a pretty big show where we picked our favorites. And it was really hard to pick your favorites out of 100.
Yes.
And my co-host, she was a co-host, not a guest, is Savina, and we did pretty good.
That's the only one that you actually were the guest.
That's right. Yeah, and then there was Olivia. She sung this wonderful song that moved us to tears. And
Prism for Thought? For Profit?
No, that is still from...
Still the same one? Oh, okay.
From 100, so Olivia sung this wonderful song for us. In fact, she has promised to sing us out today, so you will hear that song again at the end of our show today. And wonderful young lady, and she really moved us with her song here. And Cliff, if I can get you to move for a minute, please. Thank you. And so she's just singing her heart out there.
Prison for Profit. Here we
Prison
go.
For Profit. We discussed Unicor, Anti-Slavery Act, Patricia Michael and Tom Stahl. We have, actually, we took those two shows and turned them into a feature workshop. Feature standing for Fully Informed Jewelry Association. So we really did quite well with those. And they are pretty much all over the country right now. Yeah. I don't think any of the shows got legs as fast as this one. They were just, you know.
Yeah.
Just grew legs and off they went.
That's good.
Yeah. Now, we are pretty much at the end of this clip here. And this was Crystal Woman. Aaliyah Leyland, and this is Bernie Charlesar, our director we're talking about here. And this was a bilingual show And he translated whatever she said into Spanish, and she was talking about the illegals that they shoot it at the border, you know.
Yes.
And that was really close to her heart. So in this show went, got legs too, and it went pretty much to a lot of places. And then this one here, we had just experimented with our new setup, and everybody said, smile, Lillian. So I did. And it was one of the first ones when we used our different background.
Government abduction and mind control.
Yes, that's my internet show. You can access this show at www.sigeria.com. There will be a whole series of shows of that nature on my webpage. And then this is Fija. Larry Dodge again, he is the founder of the Fully Informed Jury Association. And this year he was the recipient of the Human of the Year Award. And like I said, he came from Wyoming, and it was such a wonderful visit. The Human of the Year Award last year, Stephen Maddox.
Maddox, yes, he got it last year.
One of our local people got it. And the reason we give the Human of the Year Award, it represents a person that does unselfishly, does what really, really good things for just
others.
So many. And that's why we gave the award to Larry Dodge this year. And then what we have coming up is a few days ago, you need to tell the story about when you took your camera and you ran outside.
Yes, I was sitting in my living room watching TV, and all of a sudden I was told to look over out the window, and I did, and I seen a big bright light. So I grabbed my camera and went outside and filmed a UFO.
A UFO. Now, where my head is at this time, eventually you will see the moon, so you don't think that's the moon. My face is a little bit in the way there when the moon finally does come up. And so I'll let you tell the story about the UFO.
Okay.
Talk.
Well,
she said, yes, she's up.
This is what I was filming first, and I seen the pink edges. And it was raining, and you can actually hear the rain, but the moon was out. And
yeah, my head is a little bit in the way there.
It kept getting bigger, and then it would go away, and it would get real small, almost gone. There's a little over 6 minutes of taping there. I wasn't a pro, but I did the best I could do with what I had at the time. Since then, I've had quite a few of them come to my house, and they've all been the same nature. We believe that they're the triangular-shaped
ones. Yeah, actually, this is the first time, and probably the only time we show you this footage, because tomorrow we're going to turn it over to Peter Davenport from the UFO Reporting Center so they can analyze it.
Right, and here if you look closely, you could see the pink diamond-shaped lights that go northeast, south, and west. It's a yellow center. It's shaped like a plug-in on the wall. But it's really spinning. You could see it spinning like a tire going backwards.
Well, the reason I'm so impressed with this one there is my face is really in the way here because the moon is going to come up.
Yeah, we need our faces to disappear.
If I could just, yeah. Anyway, what happens here is this is one of the best footages I've ever seen because look at it. You see,
well, thank you.
See, we have computers that take all this apart, and what happens is you have all the elements. You have the trees, you have the moon,
the rain.
You can hear the rain, and so there is just no way that anybody could say that this is not that is not actual footage. Do you think you caught up with it immediately?
Not that particular filming of it, no.
Can we stay with that clip, please? Thank you. Now, that was the moon. And then that this is the craft again.
Mm-hmm.
Missed that moon shot there. Now I would assume that when they picked that apart, they find a whole lot of metal in there. Did you not tell me it appeared like something was opening up there?
Yes, that's what I thought right there. But after I seen it on the VCR, it was a tree limb. Going through it, you know. But it was dark outside, mm-hmm. and my camera doesn't light up or anything, so.
And it was raining. Now here.
There's
wonderful, thank you. We have a shot of the moon there. And then you see it there?
Mm-hmm.
How big do you think about?
As big as my eyes could see a basketball, but it was still miles and miles away.
I like for you to know, this is for the friends that ever called the UFO Reporting Center. Peter Davenport is going to ask you how big was it. And if you say it's like as far as my eyes could see, like a, what kind of ball?
Basketball.
He says, I can't do anything with that. So that's one way not to report. Not to report it.
It's hard to estimate the distance it was or the size.
Did you hear any sound?
No. No sound.
Yeah. It's no sound on this tape either other than the rain.
Mm-hmm.
And then you got real excited.
Yes, I did.
In the very beginning, when we started, the way it worked, all the tapes was free. So other than a membership, a person could actually do all of this without any money per se. So, but I decided that I really wanted to have a library of all this hard work that we did. And so I went out to get help with tapes. At that time we worked with S tapes, and they were like $7 or $8 a piece, and I needed several of those a month. And so I went to the good guys and pleaded my case, and sure enough, here they came and they said, oh, we'd love to. And with that, we got the sponsors that I needed for the tapes, and the people volunteered. They brought us food and things like that. And all the work that I've ever done is public domain. That means you have a right to copy. Please send it to your friends. I worked hard to be very stingy with my work, and that's why I ask you to tape it in part. If you see anything there that refresh your memory and that you like, give me a call, and I'll see to that you get a DVD. We don't have videos anymore. That you get a DVD, and it would really be my pleasure to accommodate you on that. And so this kind of almost concludes show number one from the review of the visits with a person of high strangeness that we did throughout the years. And we're going to start with 2001 because a lot of changes came along. Things never stayed the same. And so please remember for next week to make your recorder available. So all you have to do is push a button on the bulletin board, it'll tell you, on the community board, it will tell you when it's time for the show to come on. And so I guess we'll see you next week, and hope you enjoyed an overview of 1999 and 2000. See you next week.
I'd like to thank you for all the fun. And you took us here. Take us there. And it's just because Take us here, and you take us there.